I needed to install a new SSD in my computer. So I bought this cheap NVMe M2 SSD. That is actually 512 gigabytes. So it's not so big, but it's not so small either. It's okay for my needs. I bought this SSD to have more storage available in my computer and actually to do a little upgrade. Because yeah, this NVMe is faster than my normal SSD that I also have in my computer. So this is pretty simple to install on my motherboard. Just tighten some screws and connect it in the right PCI port. And we're done, basically. So let's do a fresh Debian install on this NVMe. And I will tell you how I set up my machine and how I prepare it for audio production on Linux. Let's get started. Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. Before we go on, I want to thank you for all the comments, all the likes to my last video. I really appreciated that a lot. So today we are setting up my new Debian installation and we will take a look to the things I install and I configure when I install a new system like Debian. So let's proceed and let's first install Debian into our new SSD. Now let's go to the BIOS and let's see if my system recognizes my new SSD. As you can see, it's there. It's called SA2000, while the other one is my old one, my old SSD. So now let's boot into Debian and let's install the new system. That usually will take, I don't know, 10 minutes or less. So after we're done with Debian installation, let's install the Linux real-time kernel. As you can see, my new Debian installation comes with actually a very old kernel. We need something newer. We need some new kernel. And so I installed Linux real-time kernel 5.9. And this is cool because it will help us to have better performances when we use our computer for audio production. Okay, so now let's install Awesome WM. I was a window manager and not a desktop environment. Because I really like the workflow, I'm getting used to it and as you can see, Awesome WM looks pretty simple out of the box. But as soon as we're done with installation, we can go to copy, if you have some, your config files from your old installation. So all we have to do is to navigate to the old folder where we have to copy the old files from the folders to the new folders of Awesome WM installation. So when we have done that, we just need to restart Awesome WM and our old configuration is now installed in our new system and our fresh install. So that's pretty easy to set up Awesome WM and to backup your config files. Okay, now we need to install Jack. Jack is very useful when you have to use, for example, your Do and Firefox at the same time, or you have to connect more applications together. We will use Jack. I use it because I really need sometimes to use Firefox and use Ardour at the same time. That's my favorite Do. Or sometimes I need to stream audio to OBS, so I need Jack to sync Ardour and OBS together. So it's pretty easy to set up. You have to select your audio interface and actually you have to add two scripts to the options. These scripts are useful because you can use Pulse Audio to redirect the audio from Jack and having two programs playing at the same time. For example, you can have Firefox and Ardour. Now we need to install this Pulse Audio module called Pulse Audio Module Jack. You can just install it using apt. So now what we need to do is to add two scripts to QJack configuration. I will write them in the description below so you can use them. This one is meant to be added after the start of Jack server, and the last one that we will add is actually useful because kills all the Jack processes, so you can go back to your old driver
that you normally use. I have to actually say that jack is not mandatory if you want to come to produce audio. If you don't need to route more application together, you don't need to use jack. You can be fine with ALSA, and Ardor is pretty easy to set up without using jack. Okay, so now we need to set up real-time priority for the audio group. You have to navigate to the security folder in etc, and you have to check limits.conf file. In this case, if you install Debian, Jack 2 will configure that for you, so you don't have to do anything, because if we go in the limits.d folder and if we open up audio.conf folder, you can see that the audio group is there. There is an entry that tells you that you have real-time priority and another entry that tells you that memory is unlocked. So actually, this is pretty cool because on other systems, sometimes you have to change the limits.conf entry. If you don't have an audio group, you have to create one and you have to add that entry that you see in this audio.conf file. You have to add that in limits.conf. So, after we've installed all these things, we now need to install Ardor. That's pretty easy. To have Ardor binaries, you have to do a small donation to the Ardor team, and you can get binaries pre-compiled, or you can just compile it from source from their GitHub page. So that's not expensive too. So after I installed Ardor, I set up something, I changed some options. For example, I changed the general theme because I like this one called Cameville that actually I like more than the others. After that, there are a bunch of other options that we can change. For example, we will set up the plugin folder for Wine, and I am going to change the media recording 24-bit. Actually, I like to have the mixer full screen, like I have the editor full screen, so when I want to change from one window to the other, I just press the shortcut on my keyboard, that's Alt plus K and Alt plus J, to scroll between windows on my desktop. So I can switch, as you can see, from editor to mixer without problems. It's really fast, it's really easy to do. After I press Shift plus E, I do that to use the channel strip of the track that we are modifying on the left. So you have a chance to modify the channel strip without opening the mixer every time. Usually, before going to install Linux native plugins, I install Wine first, and after that I install YabBridge, a Windows plugin bridge actually. What I do is to go to apt folder and to modify sources.list and add a Wine repository. So sometimes you can get an error from Debian because it tells you apt-key is deprecated. In this case, you have to follow some additional steps to install Wine without having problems about the key. I will leave you a link in the description below. So when you've done that, you can start with Wine installation. Just paste the command from Wine website and you're ready to go. You'll need a recent Wine version to run YabBridge, so that's why I'm not installing the stable Wine version from Debian repository, but I'm going to install Wine testing. That's actually the 6.0 release candidate 3, so that's almost the stable 6 version. After the installation, you need to download YabBridge. You have to go in the release section and you have to download the right version for your system. Usually you also need YabBridge CTL, that's actually an application that is useful to manage your VST and your Windows plugins. So go to the download folder, extract the archives, and you have to install the files into the local share folder. After we've installed YabBridge and YabBridge CTL in local share folder, we are ready to install our plugin. And I will show you how to install a Windows plugin with YabBridge and how can you run it inside a DAW like Ardor. So first of all, after you install what Wine requires to start those programs, you can actually go to the website of the plugin and you can install the plugin pretty easily. There is one thing, by the way, that plugin that I want to install, that's called Spitfire Labs. It's actually not working if you don't create a basic and fresh wine prefix. So we have to install this program in another prefix that we'll call Wine Spitfire. But that's just a bug that happens with this program, not with other plugins too. So maybe this is something that you will not have to do. By the way, when you install the program, we can go to the local share folder and we can start YaBridge CDL. What you have to do is to add the folder where the Windows plugins are located. That's pretty simple. Just execute YaBridge and use the add command. In my case, the right path is Wine Spitfire Drive C program files VST plugins. After you located the right path, you execute the add command and be sure to write it properly. After you add it, you can write YaBridge CTL status, and that command actually allows you to see if the path that you added actually have plugins that are installed in the system. So as you can see, mine are not installed. That's because we have to use YaBridge CTL sync. Everything is working. So now if you execute YaBridge CTL status again, you can see that the plugins are installed. So after, you just have to run Ardour or your favorite DAW. In my case, I start Ardour. All I have to do is to add the path where the Windows VST are located. That's pretty easy. Just go into VST menu and you have to modify Linux VST2 path or VST3, depends on the VST. Click on add and search for the Wine folder. And it should work. YaBridge is really a good program and almost every Windows VST is working with YaBridge, so you're pretty much covered for everything. So another thing that we can do in case we use more instances of the same plugin is to create a group. You actually have to create YaBridge.toml file where you have to insert this information. If you insert the asterisk, it means that every plugin in the folder is executed with the same Wine group. That means that you will save a lot of resources that in theory can improve performances when you run the same plugin with more instances. So this is optional, it's not mandatory, but this maybe can improve performances of Windows plugins that you installed through Wine.
So thank you for watching as always, and this video was suggested by some of you in the comments. If you want to suggest me more videos to do, please write in the comments below, or like the video, or a like if you didn't like it. So thank you for watching and see you next time.